Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're coming to you from Burt's Marketplace in the Eastern Market. My guest this segment is Luther Badman Keith, the executive director of Arise Detroit. Luther, shake my hand, man. Arise Detroit has been doing a great job throughout the city. Now you, I would imagine you have a new role or a new mission under emergency management. It's not the same old city that it was a year ago.
Well, I would respectfully, strongly disagree.
Okay.
Because the role of Arise Detroit, quite frankly, is not defined by the EFM. It's not defined by the mayor, the governor, or even the president, for that matter. It's defined by the people of Detroit and the will and the commitment of the people of the city to grab control of the issues they can control, be part of the solution. And that's not based on who's in office. That's based on how badly we want to create this kind of city that's safe for our children, for our seniors, and for everyone who wants to live and work and play in Detroit. So while others can debate the political whims of this or that, there's a place for that. Arise Detroit, we're a non-political organization. Our focus and mission is around one thing. If you want a better Detroit, how can we partner? How can we work together? How can we get people to mentor, to tutor, to clean up neighborhoods, to come together in a way that makes a difference in a positive way? So that's been our mission from the beginning when we were founded in 2006. That's our mission today, and will continue to be our mission in the future. As it relates to the EFM, though, and political officials, and we've worked with all administrations from the time that we were founded, in regards to if we can play a role that speaks to moving the city forward on some level with all of the neighborhood groups, because we're now a coalition of more than 400 organizations, churches, black clubs, community groups in every part of the city, we'll play that role. But quite frankly, we're too busy working to get caught up in the EFM and all the rest of that. Every day people come into the office, they call me, they say, Luther, we need this, we need that, where can we go to get this? That's our focus, that's our goal. So that's a long way of answering your question, that our work is not defined by that, but it's a very important work. And to the extent that Detroit's in a deep hole, our work is more important than ever. So we have to recommit, come together in ways, new ways, creative ways to fight crime, to employ people, to make our neighborhoods safer and stronger.
Well, speaking of coming together and bringing forging partnerships, the FPD, one of our sponsors, provided you water during Detroit Neighborhoods Day last year.
Yeah.
Talk about Detroit's Neighborhoods Day. Because a lot of people don't really get
it. Neighborhoods Day is truly unique. As a matter of fact, if you're listening out there, CNN and all those other folks, we think we have something that is truly worth the nation paying attention to. We started it 6 years ago. It'll be the 7th annual, August the 3rd, always the first Saturday of every August. On this day, we ask churches, community groups, and black clubs, instead of everybody going down to Hart Plaza or Belle Isle, and there's no place for that, we say do something in your own neighborhood on this day to show what you're doing throughout the year to make a difference. Some people clean up neighborhoods. Some people plant gardens. Some people build houses with Habitat for Humanity. Some people have health fairs, collect backpacks for going back to school. Some people renovate neighborhoods. We started the first year with 55 events on the same day, sun up to sundown. Last year we had 200. We had people adopting schools, creating safe school groups, boarding houses. And this year we're very excited. We're going to be taking on some new corporate partners that we can't announce yet, but they're very big, and we're going to again be deploying thousands of people.
I was impressed with the corporate partners you had last year.
Yes.
I can't believe something bigger than that.
We've had tremendous support from the financial institutions in town, from the media, and I won't name any names because I'll leave somebody out. But I like to say Arise Detroit is not something where it's our time. It's a community organization that the community wants to come to. And all we are doing is reaching out to people who respond. Arise Detroit would not exist, Steve, if people didn't have the need to connect and to be part of something bigger. So what we do with Neighborhoods Day and Arise Detroit in general, we let people know that in Southwest Detroit, Northeast Detroit, there's somebody working to clean up a corner just like you are. There's somebody trying to raise up a child just like you are. Mm-hmm. There's somebody trying to look out for a senior just like you are. In Southwest Detroit, in Northeast Detroit, downtown, midtown, it's about family.
Okay, Luther, how do people get involved? How do they contact Arise Detroit? They want to volunteer.
Well, there are two ways to do that. You can call us at 313-921-1955.
313-921-1955.
Let me slow that down. Or go to our website, www.arisedetroit.org, and you can send us an email, info@arisedetroit.org. And we're revamping our website and upgrading our social media to move it to the next level this year. And I want to thank you, Steve, for your personal support, extending us this opportunity, because as a former journalist myself, the media is highly, highly important to what we do.
Well, and I want you to know
that I appreciate that.
I just want you to know we're only 70 hits from having 50,000 views.
Wow.
Okay, so you're going to be seen worldwide.
Okay.
But I want you to stick with me, because when we come back, we're going to talk about your other hat, the blues.
Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, when we come back, we'll be with Luther Badman Keith.